Hey guys, my name is Anastasia. Welcome to Arteza Camp. Today we're creating a simple architectural illustration using complex objects on the reference. I hope it will be interesting and useful for you. Let's get started. Step 1. Draw the house. To make my sketch of the house, I am using a picture from the internet as my reference. I decide to do the blue house, but I'm going to add a few changes to make it uniquely my own. The roof is a trapezoid, so I draw it first. The house itself is a rectangle. Next, I add in the windows and the front door, using smaller rectangles, and draw the chimney. Recommendations. When using gouache, it's best to use a heavier paper of at least 140 LB or 300 GSM. This will ensure your paper won't warp once it gets wet. For my initial sketch, I like to use an HB pencil or one with a very hard lead. This gives me the lightest lines, so I don't worry about being able to see them once the painting is done. They are also very easy to erase as I work on my drawing. Whenever working on any complex object or reference, I mentally divide it into simple forms. Then it will be clearer where to start and how to construct it. I'm giving my house a cute attic window with a roof and a window box. Next, I add two potted shrubs in front and place an elongated tree on the right. At the bottom, I add a stone pathway with a few small ovals on the ground in front of the house. Then, I draw a couple of clouds in the sky. Now that my sketch is complete, I erase the hardness of the pencil lines, so all that remains is a light outline. Step 2. Set up the palette. It's time to paint. The first thing to do is to set up your palette with all the colors you're going to use. For this painting, here are the colors you will need. A163 white. A154 sky blue. A133 peach. A138 Aegean Blue. A110 Ultramarine Blue. A137 Mauve. A164 Sap Green, A102 Lemon Yellow, A145 Vermilion Red, A128 Latte Brown. It's also good to have 2 cups or jars of water, one for cleaning your brush, one for color mixing or thinning. I also always have a paper towel ready to dab my brush on in case I get too much paint on it. Step 3. Paint the large shapes first. For all the rectangular shapes or forms that have straight edges, I prefer to use my flat brush. This gives me a nice even line and fills in the area quickly and smoothly. I begin with the roof with A133. For the facade of the house, I mix white with A154. I also use this hue on the front of the attic window and the chimney. I add more white to get a lighter shade of blue that I use for the clouds. Next, I work on filling in the flower pots next to the house with a mix of A145, white, and a bit of A102. I decide to have one of the upstairs windows open with a small plant on the windowsill, so I paint a tiny pot there using A128 mixed with a tad of white. I mix together A138 and A110 to paint the inside of all the windows. For the door, I give it a coat of a mixture of A137 and A133. Using A137, A110, and white, I paint the roof of the attic window. With that same shade, I place a darker shadow under the house's roof, a shadow on the waterspout, and shadows on the chimney. I paint the attic window more carefully, using the same colors that were used to paint the front of the house. It's time to work on the tree and shrubbery. I add rows and layers of A138, A110, A164, A102, and white. Note how I've gone from the darkest color to the lightest. This way, I will end up with bright highlights. Step 4. Add the details. The details I'll add will really make this look like a house. So I start with the window frames, painting them in white. To give them even more life, I add some open shutters. Underneath all the windows and the shutters, I use A137 for shadowing. On the second floor window, I add plants to the little pot, as well as in the window box below the attic window. I continue with details on the bushes, adding leaves and shadows under those pots. I detail the door. On the ground in front of the house, I've drawn small ovals to imitate stepping stones. These I color in with A128, and to give them more volume, I place accent shadows with A137. It's good to take a moment and step back from your painting to see if there's anything else you need to add or adjust. This is when I supplement with shadows and overtones, detail the roof, and add even more leaves to the plants. I'd love to hear what you think about this versatile medium. Leave me your comments in the section below. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.